Boruto episode 218, Kurama's death. A very sad moment, but today I explain why Kurama might return. Also, only small percentage of the people who watch our videos are actually subscribed. So if you end up liking this video, consider subscribing. Please enjoy this video, let's go! Let's start with the general rule for tailed beasts. It has been clearly mentioned several times in the Naruto series that a Bijuu can never really die. But there are people who say that this rule suddenly no longer applies. And to be fair, they have a very valid reason to believe this. Because Kurama himself has stated that he will indeed 100% die. Kurama, as one of the tailed beasts, certainly knows a lot about his own creation, chakra, and the history of Earth and humanity. Kurama is undeniably a very powerful being and knows about the Bijuu rebirth, so his statement that his death is final must be very believable. But still, Kurama is not omniscient. He does not know or understand everything. We must keep that in mind. There are even concepts that his creator Hagoromo doesn't know or understand. However, since Kurama has confirmed his death, we must assume this to be the truth for now. The question, however, is whether there could be a reason which Kurama himself doesn't know, why he suddenly did not really die after all, and whether this reason has a plausible explanation for why and how Kurama could return. I'm sure everyone is somewhat familiar with the concept that tailed beasts can't actually die, as they are nothing more than pure chakra, and when they die they just respawn. As was the case with the three-tailed beasts. Kushina herself once said that the death of the Bijuus is only temporary. Tsunade has also confirmed that the Bijuus are immortal beings, and literally at least 5 other people have mentioned this throughout the series. So pure chakra cannot be destroyed, and since Kurama is made of pure chakra, he cannot die. But the new transformation literally destroys the chakra that Kurama is made of, and then creates this kind of new nuclear fusion chakra, until all of Kurama's chakra is completely used up. Kurama says that this is not the same as the Bijuu extraction, so he cannot respawn, but supposedly disappears forever. Kurama said that this new mode is a technique where he uses all his power. The name of this new mode is Baryon Mode. And now we come to the scientific part. Because of the naming, we can actually understand how this mode works and thus understand why Kurama believes that he will definitely die. Baryons are composite subatomic particles consisting of an odd number of quarks. While quarks are the basic building blocks of matter, they are found primarily in protons and neutrons. So basically the foundation of life. And here we must remember how Kurama was created. He's pure energy. By energy we mean chakra, which is the form of energy in the Naruto world. Kurama explains the new form similar to how the sun generates energy. This is nuclear fusion. In the world of Naruto, this means that all chakra is connected. So every time they lose a part of their life, Ishiki's life is also cut off when they come in contact with him. Thus, Kurama uses his own life force by absorbing Ishiki's life force while Naruto is beating on him. Kurama's chakra serve as the core to create a completely different, new kind of energy. This new energy is different from normal chakra. Kurama says that with the other modes, you take chakra that you get from elsewhere and just use it. While this new Baryon form actually consumes its own chakra and life force as raw material to give Naruto a momentary power boost. This means that Kurama does not die like normal tailed beasts that can respawn later, but that the core of his existence, namely chakra, is used to create a reaction that releases a completely new energy, with which the basis of Kurama's existence disappears bit by bit. To understand why I see the possibility of Kurama returning as a new entity, we need to understand how he was created in the first place. We know that Hagoromo created the 10 beasts with the creation of all things technique. The creation of all things technique enables the user to transform imagination into reality. It is explained that he first used imagination and spiritual energy, which is the basis of the yin chakra, to create physical forms out of nothing. Then by applying vitality and the physical energy that forms the basis of the yang chakra, he breathed life in the resulting creation. Therefore, the tailed beasts have a personality due to spiritual energy and a body due to physical energy. Now we know that the Boruto series is strongly based on scientific principles, as is the case with the Baryon principle. And the creation of all things, especially the creation of the tailed beasts, is also based on the most famous theorem in physics. Albert Einstein said that the energy can be transformed into matter. Mass and energy are closely related. Atomic bombs and nuclear reactions like nuclear fusion, used in the new Baryon mode, are practical examples of the formula working in one direction, turning matter into energy. And according to Einstein, the reverse is also possible, just as Hagoromo used pure energy in the form of chakra to create Kurama. The fact that Kishimoto used this concept for the new Baryon mode shows that the opposite is possible too, which as mentioned was proven already when Hagoromo created the tailed beasts. Now Kurama was transformed by nuclear reactions again into pure energy. Basically, Kurama as well as Hagoromo applied the principle of matter and energy. Thus it is confirmed that the energy can also be transformed back into matter if this energy forms mass again. This is something different than a revival, as it was normally the case with the tailed beasts if they died, but it would be rather a reconstruction of the energy into matter. But the problem is that Hagoromo used spiritual energy to give Kurama a personality, but this was completely destroyed in the transformation from matter back to energy when Naruto used Baryon mode. If this energy somehow returns to its former physical state, Kurama will then no longer be Kurama, as the energy will form a completely new personality. Although this tailed beast will be a nine-tailed fox again, it will no longer identify itself as Kurama because this being would have lost all memories. But it's a fact that the law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. Therefore, Kurama's energy was released and is now floating around somewhere. And with that, it's possible that a new nine-tailed beast could return, but we have to accept that the Kurama we know is gone. The main purpose was not to kill Kurama, but to weaken Naruto. So far, Naruto and Sasuke have been used to keep the action and power level higher than in Naruto Shippuden. Because let's face it, no one wants to see the power level go back to zero. So Naruto and Sasuke were used to maintain power until Boruto is strong enough. Which is almost the case right now considering how strong his true potential really is. And that's exactly what the whole episode was meant to symbolize. We saw Naruto grab Kurama, but instead he grabbed his son, symbolizing that Naruto's time is up and now it's Boruto's turn. It is no coincidence that Kurama left the story at the same time that Sasuke lost his Rinnegan. This death was the symbolic meaning that both Naruto and Sasuke are out of the game and now it's the next generation's turn. And since the purpose of this death was not to kill Kurama, but to declare that it's now Boruto's turn, there's always the possibility that Kurama will come back to life through a new concept that Kishimoto might introduce. However, this new Kurama will most likely be a new being and definitely not return to Naruto. Through his rebirth, he would lose all his memories of past lives and be a completely new person who no longer remembers Naruto. It will be even better if Kurama gave himself a new name, so that we would have a completely different beast without any connection to Naruto. I believe in this possibility mainly because of one reason. I don't know if you guys remember the concept drawing Kishimoto did when Boruto was first announced or shortly after the first episode aired. I don't remember when exactly, but that was a long time ago. We have seen the concept of three characters to replace Naruto, Sasuke and Sakura. Boruto, Sarada and Mitsuki. They were all drawn in their future power-ups. One of them has already received the power-up shown in the concept. So we can confirm that there's a possibility that the other two could also receive the power-up shown. Mitsuki is drawn in the exact same Sage mode as was later revealed in the Boruto anime. We see the exact pattern on Sarada's future Mangekyou Sharingan. And Boruto is seen in Kyuubi mode, hinting that Kurama will go to Boruto. At least that is what was planned. Well, for Boruto to receive Kurama, it really needs a good explanation because we fans wouldn't accept it so easily if Naruto would just give Kurama to Boruto. Even if Naruto had died, we honestly wouldn't want to see that. The whole point of Boruto is to make Boruto the new main character. By giving him the exact same Bijuu in the form of Kurama would be like replacing Naruto with Boruto. When we see Naruto reach for Kurama, he actually grabbed Boruto. Which could indeed be a foreshadowing that Kurama could return in some way and then stay with Boruto, as foreshadowed by Kishimoto. What do you think? Will Kurama return? let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like. And if you are new, feel free to subscribe with the notification bell activated. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.